being a last speaker has many disadvantages. And one of them is that whatever you want to talk, most of it, maybe in bits and pieces, has been covered by very many people. And therefore, there is a repetition, and one is a little scared of the repetition. Second is when there is a last speaker, the audience is already bored to death. They are just waiting for it to be concluded, and that's the challenge I have. And when Mr. Saxena started in the beginning, he said, we got a lot of time, and let the night come, I was very happy. If I'm the last speaker, I'll be able to carry on. And before I was to move here, he told me, I have to close by 6:10. Okay. Best is always kept to the last, and therefore, SIS. I'll keep. This is the one making noise. Initially, when the discussion started, nobody was talking about global ideas and local practices. And I was just wondering at the time, have I come to a wrong session? And I was looking left and right. I hope I am there. But sooner or later, I think the theme did catch on to that. And the whole discussion of mine is on the ideas, because whatever we do, whether in e-governance, education, health, any of the areas, has come out of some idea somewhere, picked up from the consultant, picked up from the various conferences like this and so on and so forth. So if from the ideas we are going to develop e-governance, and the topic was global, how do we adopt them for the local environment? And my discussion is going to be around that, and considering a lot of points have already been discussed and talked about, I shall only elaborate those points where I think there is an additional contribution in terms of value. Otherwise, I shall skip those points. Also, if you look at the theme, we are talking about Vision 2020, and therefore it is imperative. Then when today we are talking at about 2011 and we are going to 2020, what is going to be the change in environment in terms of demographic? What is going to be the change in environment in terms of ICT? And the point that I want to make here is that by the time we reach 2020, the younger generation, which is bubbling with ideas, which is bubbling with energies, is going to be almost about 60 to 65%, greater than 35 workforce. Whereas on one side, people are talking about, when there is such large younger population, how do we look after health, how do we look after education? Simultaneously also, here is a exuberant piece of resources that we have, which can lead us to far greater heights. Here is a small structure which tells you as to what is going to be the status in the next 15 to 20 years. And if you look at it, the CAGR of the Asian countries and India in particular is going to hover around 6%, and therefore we'll be there. Also important to note is that the working workforce will be somewhere around 920 million, along with more than 60 years senior citizens, around 92 million. This point has been discussed sometime in bits and pieces, but I want to put it all together. This is where the global ideas cannot directly be interfaced with the local conditions. Multilingual, 22 official languages. Multi-religious, multi-ethnic, federal states, so many union territory, all having a different structure in terms of both governance as well as in terms of diversity. We have a multi-tiered democracy. People are talking about if one officer goes, then what happens to the project which was there? So all these problems, along with more than 250,000 all local bodies, which makes the whole situation fairly complex. If you look at the ICT perspective, we understand mobile connections are already second highest in the world. We also have tele-density, which is greater than 100 in urban and almost cross 40 in rural. Mobile penetration, which is for data is more than 48%. And when I'm talking about data services, I also include the SMS along. And broadband penetration is not that much at the moment. It is around, it's much lesser than the developed nations at the moment. But what's going to happen in 2020? With 2020, obviously, if we are not the second highest, possibly we shall be the highest by the time 2020. Mobile penetration would have been saturated. Whole India would have been connected, both wired and wire-free. And data speeds will be comparable to anyone in the best in the class. So look at this in terms of e-governance today. What is the current status? I think this has been covered and I shall skip this. But what is important to understand that look at the number of projects with various states at various levels. A lot has been initiated. I think the progress has begun. The infrastructure will be there in place. Now, it is up to us how to utilize this infrastructure. But there are some unanswered paradigms. The role of ICT in the quality of life in a common man, infrastructure and systematic improvement, and the extent of e-governance, though we keep on talking about the glimpses. But fact of the matter is, if you look at and many of the projects, of course they are there on papers. They're also there some success. But have they been executed to the last man in terms of the value addition and meeting its necessity? Possibly we have not arrived there. And there are many reasons. As we go along, we shall discuss and talk about them. Did discuss this, if we can possibly do all this in a structured manner and take the implementation to the last level, we would have achieved the vision of 2020. So what are the gaps? I think the first fundamental gap, and partly covered by many speakers earlier, not now, even in the morning, is I think when we develop policies, when we develop structures, we do not follow a two-way information sharing. Two-way information sharing could be government and the private bodies. Two-way information can be the one who is going to get the advantages of whatever we are going to implement. I think the two-way communication. And the second important part, which I believe and I think is important, is though the development is taking place in government sector in many states and so on, there's no common platform. Common platform in terms of operating system, common platform in terms of servers, common platform in terms of network connectivity, common platform in terms of devices. And so what happens is when the development is taking place in one of the states, it becomes non-replicable. And in case we want to, and in case we have to, and obviously there is absolutely no way that we can avoid this in case we want a faster progress across the nation,